Night two of the USAG Collegiate National Championships. It's the team final as we get set to crown a national champion from Westchester, Pennsylvania. Four left standing, advancing out of last night's semifinal sessions. It will be Westchester, Texas Women's, Lindenwood, and Air Force competing for the 2024 USAG national title tonight in southeastern PA. What a night of gymnastics it should be. Kevin Kopp joined by CHRISTINA CHAUVENET. CHRISTINA, anytime you get to hand out a national championship trophy, it is a special night. One of these four teams with great stories abounding tonight throughout this four-team final. Someone gets to walk away with a USAG national title here in 2024.
Absolutely, Kevin. Always excited to be on the mic with you and bringing the fans, in my opinion, one of the most underrated meets of the season, USAG Championships.
Well, absolutely. We had two semifinals yesterday, three team semifinals with two spots afforded to the two advancing teams to give us our final four on the floor tonight at the Hollinger Fieldhouse on the campus of Westchester University. And we had plenty of drama on day one. We already handed out a little bit of hardware. We'll talk some about that momentarily. But as it pertains to the team qualifications, here's what it looked like. In the afternoon session, pretty easy first place victory there for Texas Women's, a 195-175, putting them into tonight's final. Air Force taking second with a 193-675 to eliminate Cornell, who scored 193-025. In the night session, the highest overall score put up by the number one seed, Lindenwood, 195-625 last night, highlighted by that 49-2. They opened the meet in fine fashion on floor and led wire to wire. And then a mild upset of sorts as Westchester scored a 193-975, and the home team defeated Brown, 192-525 for the Bears, which gives us our four remaining teams, Texas Women's, Air Force, Lindenwood, and Westchester. CHRISTINA, having the opportunity to compete on their home floor will be something special for Barbara Cordova's Rams.
Absolutely, and this is the first time this team has qualified to USAG Finals, and so it's really emotional for them. They're going to be in Olympic order, and so it's going to be a great night for them. Of course, Lindenwood coming in both as a statistical favorite, and unfortunately, this is their last meet as a team. Lindenwood cutting the gymnastics program after the season. What a loss for the gymnastics community, but honored to be on the mic for their last team meet.
You're absolutely right, CHRISTINA, and obviously it's a loss for the sport anytime you have a program that's no longer going to be sponsored at the NCAA level, but Lindenwood especially, given what they have done throughout this short history, but my goodness, it has been bright. An NCAA Division I regional qualifier, a multiple-time MIC champion, and they get the chance to go out as the defending champions here at USAG's. They get to go out on top. They are certainly a sentimental favorite, as is Westchester at home. But you've got great stories all over. Texas Women's, a 12-time USAG national champion, trying to get back on top, but they won 2 years ago. And Air Force, great stories throughout that service academy, making a run here to the Final Four. So, I mean, you can look at this any different way. And again, it's got terrific storylines, and I echo your sentiment. A really underrated championship, and it should be a heck of a lot of fun tonight. All right, let's take a look as we get set to start tonight's competition with our sponsors who have made tonight possible. We want to be sure to thank them, and we'll start with Brandywine Valley. Chester County Tourism welcomes you to Chester County's Brandywine Valley. Inspire your visit at brandywinevalley.com. The heart of America's garden capital, springtime in the Brandywine Valley is botanical bliss. Stroll lush gardens in full bloom, from artfully curated spring blooms at Longwood Gardens to natural arboretums bursting with azaleas and wildflowers of every color. Visit www.brandywinevalley.com or instagram.com/brandywinevalley. Synergy Gymnastics in Malvern, Pennsylvania is proud to be sponsoring the 2024 Collegiate National Championships, wishing best of luck to all the athletes and teams at this year's competition. Founded and led by women who believe in the power of female unity, we are committed to building a culture of teamwork, caring, respect, empathy, energy, and grit. Visit SynergyGymnasticsPA.com or Instagram.com/SynergyGymnasticsPA. Malvern, Pennsylvania, just 15 minutes from the host site of tonight's competition, Westchester University. DGS, striving for perfection. DGS is the largest gymnastics supply company in the United States and the official grip supplier for the USA Gymnastics men's and women's national teams. Your source for everything gymnastics for 30 years. Visit gymsupply.com or instagram.com/DGSGymSupply. And as a former competitor of this championship, LaFleur's Gymnastics would like to congratulate and wish good luck to every gymnast in tonight's competition. LaFleur's Gymnastics in Largo, Florida, opened since 1980. LaFleur's prides itself on running one of the best gymnastics-only training facilities in the Tampa-St. Pete area. Visit www.lafleursgymnastics.com or instagram.com/lafleurs_largo_gymnastics. Known as the Big Meat on Market Street, at Lorenzo's Steaks, we are home to the best cheesesteaks and hoagies. Whether it's our 14-ounce hand-cut ribeye steaks or our 2-pound cut-to-order hoagies, we have something for everyone. We have been voted number one hoagies and cheesesteaks in Chester County. Visit lorenzosteaks.com or instagram.com/lorenzosteaksandhoagies. CIC for life and annuities. We're a full-service brokerage agency providing products, marketing, and underwriting support for financial and insurance professionals. Our vision is to improve the lives of others through life insurance solutions and by providing leading insurance opportunities through products, marketing, underwriting, and case management support for financial professionals. Visit COASTALIC.net, just a 15-minute drive from Westchester University. And last but not least, you can eat, drink, and bowl. Palace is a one-of-a-kind bowling alley and entertainment center offering fun for the entire family that they'll enjoy. Family-friendly bowling featuring a full-service bar, snack bar, leagues, parties, and more. Bowling is a timeless source of fun that knows no age limits. Reserve a lane today by visiting www.thepalacebowling.com or instagram.com/thepalacebowling. Located in Downingtown, Pennsylvania, just a 15-minute drive from here in Westchester University. And once again, thank you to our sponsors for making tonight's meet possible as we get set for the USAG Team Finals. CHRISTINA, should be a good one tonight as we get set for the teams to be introduced. Again, our four teams left standing out of yesterday's semifinals, Westchester, Texas Women's, Lindenwood, and Air Force as we get set to get underway. And CHRISTINA, obviously, once this gets going, we'll have Westchester, you mentioned, in Olympic order. They'll get to start on vault. Texas Women's will begin on bars, Lindenwood on beam, and Air Force on floor, and just really excited to get this competition underway this evening.
Absolutely, and you know, Lindenwood, as you mentioned, this is their last meet. They are, you mentioned they were the sentimental favorite, also the statistical favorite coming into this meet. They're coming off that MIC championship last weekend, scored above 196 there. So, you know, it's gonna be a really tight battle. I'm so excited to see these teams go head to head.
Absolutely. I think 196 is kind of that magic number that's out there tonight. We talk about that a lot. It's looking at a 49 or above on all four events. Lindenwood got close, got off to a good start last night on floor, scored a 49-2, jumped out to an early lead, really weren't pushed in that second semifinal. 195-7, they had the highest qualifying score of any of the four teams tonight. Texas Women's had the second highest, 195-175. You had Westchester qualify with a 193.975 and Air Force a 193.675. And certainly Lindenwood and Texas Women's, they've got a great rivalry going, CHRISTINA. They have met up at the conference level and here at the USAG National Championship level as well, and expect that to be another heavyweight matchup tonight.
Absolutely, and you know, Texas Women Lindenwood, as you mentioned, they've been going back and forth all season. They have been in a higher scoring threshold generally than Air Force, but Air Force didn't have their best meet on Friday night. You know, still qualified through, but really they're capable of pushing those numbers as well. Westchester hasn't quite been up in that scoring threshold, but they're also at home. They got the home crowd. They have that sentiment going, making their first USAG finals. So, you know, four events, lots can happen.
No doubt about it, and I think you look at Lindenwood obviously having the highest ceiling. They're the only team in this competition that's posted a score of 197 this year, scraping above that 197 mark with a season-best 197.075. They've got the highest NQS of any of the four teams, just a shade below a 196 at 195.940. But Air Force actually has the second highest high score of any of the four teams in this competition. They've gone 196.4 this year. They've put up an astounding 49.4 on bars. So they've got a ceiling. And I think talking with each of these coaches this week, as we had the opportunity to do, you feel that all of these coaches still think that they've got their best gymnastics out in front of them. Thought it was interesting, even some of the statistical favorites in Lindenwood and Texas Women's, when you talk to their coaches, I don't think that anyone has felt like yet that they have put their very best meet together. And this is obviously the most important time when you want to be peaking here at the Collegiate National Championships. And so maybe tonight could be the night. I think 24 for 24 is going to be a prerequisite. And who can pull out those extra tenths to get the victory tonight is going to make the difference. And as our teams get set to be introduced here on the floor at the Hollinger Fieldhouse, we're going to turn it over to Westchester Public Address to meet tonight's teams.
From Chandler, Arizona, Jaden Kasuf. A junior from Mays Landing, New Jersey, Hannah Applebeck. A grad student from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Gayla Goodwin. A senior from Easley, South Carolina, Hannah Moon. A junior from Suffolk, Virginia, Trinity Cadries. A grad student from Rentham, Massachusetts, Sydney Lopez. A freshman from Parker, Colorado, Ellie Brownfield. A junior from Makina, Illinois, Kaylee Cooper. A sophomore from St. Charles, Missouri, Reese Beckley. A senior from Belleville, Illinois, Ray Jones. A senior from Dallas, Georgia, Simone Evans. A senior from Murfreesboro, Tennessee, Savannah Newsom. A freshman from Chatsworth, California, Kayla Rangold. A senior from Tulsa, Oklahoma, Madison Rush. A sophomore from Memphis, Tennessee, Allie Berkeley. A freshman from West Des Moines, Iowa, Leah Parton. A sophomore from Williamsburg, Iowa, Jaylee Jones. A sophomore from Shawnee, Kansas, Samantha Pencil. And a senior from Douglasville, PA, Nicole Rochek. And now for Texas Women University, from Newton, Georgia, Ruby Doors. A senior from Carmel, California, Maddie Gosel. A sophomore from Longmont, Colorado, Brooke Ferrari. A junior from the Ribbons, Texas, Lady Hunt. A senior from Bixby, Oklahoma, Daisy Woodring. A freshman from Gonzales, Louisiana, Bailey Bourgeois. A freshman from Holly Springs, North Carolina, Sophie Hernandez. A senior from Waxahachie, Texas, Emily Six. A freshman from Palatine, Illinois, Sophie Steffen. A sophomore from Littleton, Colorado, Cammy Zarengo. A freshman from Severn, Maryland, Aaliyah Gilmore. A senior from Kent, Washington, Caitlin Hoyland. A freshman from New Hill, North Carolina, Caroline Bounds. A junior from Germantown, Tennessee, Delaney Burns. A senior from Longview, Texas, Steely King. A junior from Tampa, Florida, Emma Berkridge. And a freshman from Red. Texas Belinda Brokey. A sophomore from Richmond, Indiana, Addison Moore. A senior from Millbay, New Jersey, Kimmy Kincaid. A freshman from Arvada, Colorado, Peyton Jenkins. A junior from Monument, Colorado, Alexa Clark. A freshman from Lee Summit, Missouri, Claire Wallace. A freshman from Las Vegas, Nevada, Rosa Juarez-Baez. A junior from Simi Valley, California, Gabriella Mackey. A sophomore from Crystal Lake, Illinois, Gracie Willis. A freshman from Wisconsin, Maggie Swipe. A freshman from Annapolis, Maryland, Chelsea Boyer. A junior from South Berwick, Maine, Ayla McKean. A sophomore from Atlanta, Georgia, Madison Carlisle. A sophomore from Martinsville, Oklahoma, Kylie Green. A senior from Frisco, Texas, Grace Nelson. A sophomore from Gross Isle, Michigan, Janie Ottenbeck. A sophomore from Claremont, Florida, Gabriella Hartley. And a sophomore from Littleton, Colorado, Gianna Martina.
Jen Perry.
On the beam, Adriana Beck, Darren Reynolds. Jenna Carrico, and Alan Reinberg. And you'll meet referees at Sandra Horsetbo and Aurora Winter.
As we look at the competition order for tonight, we'll give you the order one more time. In rotation one, it'll be Westchester on vault, Texas Woman's on uneven bars, balance beam, Lindenwood, and on floor exercise, Air Force. Westchester wins the random draw. If you can win that, they get the home order here on their home floor. Nice how that works out for the Rams. So they'll be on bars in the second rotation, beam, and finish on floor. Texas Women's goes from bars, beam, floor, and will finish on vault. Lindenwood starts on beam, will go to floor, vault, and finish on the uneven bars. And Air Force, starting on floor exercise, will go to vault, bars, and finish on beam. So four rotations, no individuals tonight, just the four teams and some hardware to give out. A 2024 USAG National Championship tonight. And obviously, we thank you for being with us here on the Virtius main broadcast. But this is not the only option for you tonight. If you are looking for more detailed coverage of any of the individual events, we've got you covered. You can simply click below the main video window to get apparatus streams, vault, bars, beam, or floor. You can get them in full screen. Now, you won't get our insightful and brilliant commentary, but you will get perhaps a better view if you're interested in following a particular team. So you can check all of that out throughout the evening tonight.
Both of us might need a break from us on the CHRISTINA, you know, so if you need a break for our commentary, you can flip over to one of the
That's
events
actually, yeah.
Join
Maybe
us
I
back
should,
in.
I should promote that as a feature and not a bug, right? Yeah, you can escape us. All right, well, let's go meet our teams and get to discuss in a little bit further detail. Head coach of Westchester is Barbara Cordova. Obviously, this team making history, reaching the USAG team final for the first time to do it on their home floor. CHRISTINA, extra special. This will be a night to remember for them.
Absolutely. And, you know, one of the interesting things, I got to commentate their first meet of the season when they were at Maryland. So got a chance to talk to Coach Cordova at the beginning of the season about their goals for USAGs, knowing that they were hosting. And so I know that's something that they've really been working towards. Super monumental for them, well-deserved to make it into this final, as you mentioned, as the host.
Westchester in NQS terms, number 62 in the nation with an NQS of 193.955. You look at their score from yesterday, 193.975 to advance to tonight's competition. Their high score this year is the lowest of the four teams in competition, mid-194 to 194.375. And they're going to have to find a way. Now, vault is going to be a tough place for them to start. Just in terms of start values, they are not going to compete with the bigger teams in tonight's competition. Texas women's, and Lindenwood have a little bit higher ceiling than Air Force and Westchester on vault. So they're going to have to go out and execute at or near their best and hope for things to fall into place for them this evening.
Yeah, I agree with you, Kevin. And, you know, just a reminder for folks that your Chenko layout that you're going to see from several of the Westchester gymnasts starts at a 9.75 compared to those Yurchenko layout fulls at the 9.95. So that's the magnitude of difference that we're talking about here. And we'll highlight for you within the, some of the different start values. Sarah Eskew, a real highlight for me in this lineup, does that full-on tuck off.
And you look at the full lineup, Eskew is in the anchor position. Bridget Sullivan will lead off, followed by CHRISTINA Rodriguez. Kara Vargo will be third. Corinne Gruber will be fourth. Jordan Coleman fifth. And Sarah Eskew in the sixth position. So that's Westchester. We'll go over to bars now. Texas women's head coach Lisa Bowerman. They're 51st in the country. NQS entering tonight of 195. 575. This is a team with a terrific history, CHRISTINA. They know what it takes to get to the top of this USAG mountain. They've done it 12 times in program history, as recently as 2022, and fully expect that they will be in the hunt this evening.
Absolutely, and this is a strong place for them to start. They have a lot of really great bar workers, dynamic bar workers through that. That being said, not their best rotation that I've seen from them on Friday. A couple handstand issues and landing deductions. So that's a place that they're really going to want to hone if they want to walk away with the championship.
Absolutely. You look at the scores for Texas women's. Qualifying score yesterday, 195-175. They'll look to improve on that tonight. They have got over that 196 mark a couple of times this season. Season high 196-275 earlier this month, 196-125 just a couple weeks ago against Centenary. So they've got what it takes to get it done tonight if they can clean up some of those issues from yesterday and execute tonight. As we get a look at the bars lineup for Texas women's, Lainey Hunt will lead off. Cami Zarlengo will be second. Caroline Bounds will be third. Aaliyah Gilmore will be fourth. Brooke Ferrari fifth. And Caitlin Hoyland in the anchor position. No change in the bars lineup from yesterday for the Pioneers.
And Caitlin Hoyland in that anchor spot, such a highlight. She is the current Texas women's record holder on that event, 9.95. Got some great pirouette work, a really nice Jaeger. So I'm excited to see that routine.
And now we will continue with Lindenwood, the favorite tonight, as we have noted, and the sentimental favorite as well, competing for the final time in the history of this program. Caitlin Arell, the head coach at Lindenwood, what a job that she has done. This program has achieved just about anything you can achieve in your first 10-plus years as a program, and they will look to go out on top tonight.
Yeah, and again, I think they have some really nice beam workers here. They're led by Nia Krause, individual qualifier for regionals this year. She's got absolutely great lines on this event, and I'm really excited to see them. I think this is, you know, it's a challenging place to start, but I think Lindenwood's up to the task.
Their qualifying score yesterday, a 195.7. That was the highest score in yesterday's semifinal competition, and their season high. We noted they are the only team in competition tonight to break a 197 this season. They went 197.075, and certainly would love to get back into that rarefied air this evening as we look at their beam lineup. Hannah Moon will get things started. Jaden Cossett will be second. Jaylee Jones will be third. Madison Rush fourth. Hannah Applegate will be fifth, and then Nia Krause, who you mentioned, CHRISTINA, got that great experience of getting to compete in Ann Arbor in the NCAA regional. She was a qualifier, scored 9.7 up there in Michigan. She is absolutely spectacular and will be a highlight for Lindenwood there. As we go over to our fourth and final team tonight, starting on floor is Air Force, coached by Jennifer Green, two-time USAG national champions back in the early part of this century in 01 and 02. They scored a 193.675 yesterday. They've been into that mid-195 mark this season, and they will look for a performance in that caliber tonight. Ayla McKean will lead off. Madison Carlisle will be sitting. Gianna Martina third. You've got Gabriella Messia fifth, and Maggie Slife. Obviously, CHRISTINA, one to keep an eye on in that anchor position as we are officially underway. Here's the look we'll be showing you for most of the night, so you won't miss a single routine here on the stream. Texas women's already underway on bars with Lainey Hunt.
And full pirouette into that double back. Just had to take that hop forward. Comes in a little short there. But overall, nice start for Texas women's.
All right, so the first routine complete. That's Hunt for Texas women's. Hannah Moon will get started for Lindenwood over on the beam. Westchester going to start with Bridget Sullivan here on their home floor on vault. And now Clara Wallace underway on floor exercise for Air Force.
A clean first pass there on floor for Air Force.
Moon with a big balance check off of that series, had to put her hand down on the beam, kept it on, but she's got a major deduction coming here off the jump. Now Westchester to get underway on vault. Sullivan Yurchenko tuck full, came in a little bit short, had to take a step forward on the landing.
And Clara Wallace wrapping up there for Air Force on floor.
Yeah, and same for Moon on beam. You know, a nice finish, and obviously staying on is of paramount importance to get the night underway. Beam, I think, the toughest event to draw first, but some issues in there, and that will hopefully be the number for Lindenwood that they'll drop.
And Cammy Zarlengo here for Texas women. A little bit shy on that final cast to handstand. Nice body position and dynamics in that double layout. Just has to take that step back and I think a little leg separation in the air. We will be seeing a lot of those double layout dismounts on bars tonight. So, you know, those dynamics, the details, keeping the legs together, chest position on landing, all really critical to avoid deduction. And our apologies, that was Ayla McKean on floor for Air Force. Just a lineup change there.
On a really nice second vault for Westchester, CHRISTINA Rodriguez up second for the Rams. And a nice improvement over the opening vault there for Westchester.
Yeah, and Rodriguez has been so consistent for Westchester during her time.
Yeah, she's been excellent. Had a 9.625 yesterday, but she's had a 9.7 score this season. And you see the opening scores start to roll in the bottom right, that's the team scoreboard. Texas women's back-to-back 9.7 scores. And now up second on beam for Lindenwood will be Jaden Casa.
And Caroline Bounds getting started for Texas women's here. Some leg separation in that Maloney, but clean on the bail to handstand.
Triple series, back handspring layout, step out. Nicely done that time by Casa.
Nice pirouette work there. Just has to take that step back on the landing, but I like how she went for those handstands in the routine.
Third vaulter for Westchester, that's a Yurchenko layout. And as CHRISTINA noted, no twist. That's a 9.75 start value. Just a small step from Cara Vargo, who was not in the lineup last night for Westchester. Gainer full off the side for Lindenwood. A little circle around, but hanging on to that landing. A nice job after the opening 9.325 from Hannah Moon.
Madison Carlisle here on floor for Air Force. Air Force making some changes to their lineup did not have their best showing on floor during semifinals and hits that double back to finish. Nice job. Aaliyah Gilmore getting set on bars for Texas women's. Texas women's off to a very consistent start. All three scores 9-7 to 9-7-2-5.
We have the fourth vault for Westchester. That's Corinne Gruberg, and a little bit of a step off of that Yurchenko layout. Westchester with two left in their competition lineup.
Oh, wow, some great core strength there, holding on to that handstand. That did result in it being labored into that stalter, but I really admire the fight there because she could have easily gone over on that handstand.
No doubt about that. That is terrific fight from Gilmore over on the bars. Now getting ready to go on beam for Lindenwood. This is Jaylee Jones, who had a season best 9-8 yesterday. See the score come up for Casa at the 9-7, and you can see those judges' splits. We've got four judge panels here at USAG's. Throw out the high and low and average the middle two. Westchester up fifth on vault. Jordan Coleman, Yurchenko tucked full. In bigger vault, you see better distance from the table that time. Now, haven't been able to really clean up those landings. A little step back with the left foot, and one to come, Sarah Eskew on vault for Westchester.
And actually, Kevin, I believe that was Corinne Gruber there for Westchester. Nice landing on beam. Hangs on to that double back on floor for Gianna Martagna. Some extra power there as Brooke Ferrari gets started for Texas Women's. Brady Yeager and going right up to that handstand. Nice control in that front layout, front full on floor. Pretty double layout. Oh my gosh, I love that. The distance, the form, right on.
Well, nice job here by Texas Women setting the tone early on.
And Martina just misses that ring position on floor. Good job controlling that Rudy to straddle jump, though. And Air Force has just had some deductions here and there, started off with a couple of 9-6-5s. But, you know, I think they're going to feel good coming out with hits in those first few routines. As I mentioned, had to count a fall in the semifinals.
Madison Rush on the beam now for Lindenwood after a 9-7-2-5 from Jaylee Jones. Lindenwood has done a nice job after the early issues for Hannah Moon. We see the side summy for Rush.
I love that skill. She had really nice control on that side summy.
And again, a little trouble there. On the acro series, lifted that right leg up on the landing on that back handspring layout step out.
Yeah, I think she was off in her back handspring. I could see it when she was starting to go for that layout step out.
There's been some fight here by Lindenwood, but certainly not as clean as they would like.
And Caitlin Hoyland going for this beautiful big Jaeger, hiked Jaeger there. And she does this full pirouette into the double back. Nice job. Just a little baby hop on that landing.
Meanwhile, a stuck landing off the side of the beam on that gainer full for Madison Rush. So working through some issues. It has not been perfect for Lindenwood here in the first rotation. They've got two left, Hannah Applegate and Nia Kraus, their NCAA regional qualifier.
And Gabriella Mechia here for Air Force. Nice to see her hit that jump, that leap to jump series. Had a problem with that in qualification. The 1.5, the front layout. Goes from that difficult ring full to end the routine. She's got some great twisting form there. There are a couple of questionable split positions in that routine, but really nice tumbling in there.
You can see with the team scores in the bottom right corner, Texas Women's has set the pace. That 9.85 from Hoyland in the anchor position.
Yeah, she's so special on that event. Not quite as crisp as I've seen her on that landing, and maybe just a shy handstand, but really great dynamic Jaeger there as gold standard.
Yeah, as you noted, 9.95 season high for Hoyland, and now on the beam up fifth for Lindenwood is Hannah Applegate.
And I love to watch her on beam. She's got some unique composition, goes for that difficult switch pike jump. Come on, that's so cool. And really composed through that back handspring layout step out. And this is what I mean, the beat jump into the standing layout step out just has unique composition that you don't see very often in NCAA. Sinks into that dismount, no problem there. And our first look at Maggie Slythe on floor for Air Force. Just a little slide of that front foot in the double pike, but big air time.
We get back-to-back NCAA regional qualifiers. Slythe qualified in the all-around.
And she just, again, has such great dynamics. I love the rise that she has in that second salto in the 1.5 front layout. She just overturned that first switch side. Double back. I love the control she had in that. Lovely job there.
Yeah, I thought she got better as that routine went on. And it's life again, a NCAA qualifier. And we have another here in Nia Krause, who will anchor this Lindenwood beam rotation on the left side of your screen. Now coming full screen.
And you know, Kevin, I think that that just speaks to the level of talent that there is in USAGs. We've got athletes anchoring these lineups who are individual qualifiers, and it is tough to qualify to NCAAs as an individual. And was off with, she did a good job to be patient and correct that. Was pretty far off with her hips on landing there in that backhand spin out, step out. Keeps that connection in that difficult switch half. Yeah, not the crispest I've seen her be on beam, but that is a fighter right there, because she knew what was on the line. And even though there were a couple of places in the routine that she was a little bit under on or a little bit off, she hung on and, you know, they managed to get out of that really on a high note after that fall to begin.
Well, it's kind of a microcosm of the entire rotation there for Lindenwood. Certainly not as crisp as we have seen them be this season, but they fought really, really hard to avoid letting those mistakes snowball as we go back to Air Force.
And that ring again, tricky jump to go for. Just couldn't quite get that position. This is Valandra Brochi for Air Force.
Brochi was not in the lineup yesterday, but has scored a 9.825 on floor. She's been in the all-around this season for Air Force.
And that layout step out in there. Often gymnasts will put that in their routine when they do not have, it is a requirement to have back tumbling. So if one of your main passes does not have back tumbling in there, you can stick the round off layout, step out in there, fulfills that requirement. And nice job on that final pass there. You know, I think that Air Force is going to be happy with what they've done here. Yes, there were areas here and there, but they didn't have to count a major mistake like they did on Friday.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's really the key. They've got that high score of 9-8 right now for Maggie Slife. We'll see what this final score comes in at for Air Force. They'll get to drop their low score of 9.625, and you see Texas women's, Christina, the way that they were able to finish up those back-to-back 9.85s from Ferrari and Hoyland, they have set the standard right now, and they're going to have the first rotation lead.
Yeah, and deservedly so. I mean, you know, they really started out that rotation strong. Hoyland, Ferrari, really showing some of those superior dynamics to get into that 9.8 range, those sky-high releases, really nice handstand positions.
All right, well, we will wait on one more score for Air Force to see where they stand, but it's going to be very tight between Air Force and Lindenwood for second. Texas Women's with that 48.825 is going to open up in first place at the end of one rotation. Westchester gets through vault, 47.875, no mistakes, and certainly higher scoring potential for the Rams lays ahead as they get to continue in Olympic order. So that's where we stand at the end of one rotation, and in between each of our rotations tonight, we're going to get to hear from our head coaches in tonight's competition to talk about what the USAG Championships means to them. And we'll get to check in with the host institution, Westchester, and their head coach, Barbara Cordova, to talk about what a championship would mean to the home team tonight.
And I really feel like this championship is really one of the huge things that has made our program so successful. When I started 16 years ago, as you know, we were just trying to break 180. We went to this championship, I had one all-arounder qualify. Then the next year we had two all-arounders qualify. And then I think it was maybe in 2014 was the first year that we had an All-American. And then in 2017 was the first year we qualified as a team. And that year we had the all-around champion, Majesta Valentine. And then we've qualified as a team several more times since then. But the thing is, this championship really is the main thing that has helped grow our program, because it provides an opportunity for athletes to compete in postseason, to earn All-American status. And so it's a huge recruiting tool, because people want the opportunity to compete postseason, and this championship allows that. It's such a fun championship. We have such a good time, and you know, it has the opportunity to make it onto a final, make it onto an individual event final or a team final. So this championship means a lot to me. I'm very passionate about it. Also, for many years, I've been on, you know, the championship committee in many different roles. And it's because I'm so passionate about collegiate gymnastics and those mid-level schools getting an opportunity.
The Virtius platform. If you're joining us, it's not just a broadcast. You can get it all, lineups, live scoring, the scorecard, get to check out individual start values, the judges splits, CHRISTINA, which is something there is really no data, no piece of data that you cannot find, that you cannot uncover, that you cannot argue with your friends about on the internet. And Virtius brings it all to you. It is a delight to be able to dig in and get all of the numbers and the details beyond just the final scores that you see.
Absolutely. Really, you know, it's a gym nerd's dream to be able to look at these splits. You can check out the neutral deductions. You can check out all the start values right here in the Virtius stream.
You can also check out the leaderboards, which update in real time. You're seeing yesterday's scores, and we should mention that Morgan Price took home that individual all-around crown in yesterday's semifinal competition, but these will update live throughout the night. You can check out inside each team, their scores overall by event. Any way you want to break down the numbers, Virtius has got you covered. So whether it's the lineup, whether it's the scorecard, whether it's the leaderboard, this is your home for it. And also a reminder that in addition to our main feed, which will show you every routine from every team, if you want a better view of a particular event, or you're interested in following one particular team as they rotate around the four events tonight, we've got the apparatus streams as well right here on the Virtius platform. So all of the neat features that you could ask for as we get set for rotation number two. It will be Air Force moving to vault, Westchester to bars, Texas Women's to balance beam, and Lindenwood to floor exercise. And CHRISTINA, you have Texas Women's in the lead. They now go to beam, which has been their weakest event statistically this year. Interested to see if they can keep that momentum going, because they really brought it on bars in rotation one.
Absolutely. And, you know, having that good momentum coming into beam is going to be really critical for them. As you mentioned, not their absolute strongest event, but they still have some really great beam workers in there. So, you know, if they can carry that momentum into beam, they're going to be in a really good place.
Yeah, not to look too far ahead, but Texas Women's and Lindenwood both get to finish on their strongest event.
Right.
For Texas Women's, that's vault. For Lindenwood, that's bars. So, you know, it sets up very nicely for a couple of these teams. And we'll see what Westchester is able to do on the bars. And Air Force, of course, moving to vault as well. Air Force opening with a 48-4 as their final score comes in. So they are 0.75 behind Lindenwood for second place. Everyone chasing Texas Women's at the end of the event. As we come back live, this is a look at what's ahead. As you see, just about 45 seconds left on our touch warm-up clock. Gives us a chance just to step back, and if you're tuning in tonight, not familiar with the USAG or what the USAG National Championship is, it is the Collegiate National Championship created by USA Gymnastics to help showcase Division I, II, and III colleges who offer less than 8 full scholarships. So that's the requirement for each of the teams competing tonight. These championships celebrate opportunities for women to compete collegiately, and 2024 is a big year on the elite gymnastics calendar as well. As the NCAA calendar wraps up, we've got major upcoming meets where stars like Simone Biles, Suni Lee, and Gabby Douglas may compete, including the Core Hydration Classic May 17th and 18th in Hartford, Connecticut, the Xfinity U.S. Championships May 30th to June 2nd in Fort Worth, and then, of course, the Olympic Trials June 27th to 30th in Minneapolis, Minnesota. So a very exciting year. I know NCAA gymnastics and USAG gymnastics comes to an end in the next couple of weeks, CHRISTINA, but plenty to keep you involved here at the USA gymnastics level as we move on.
So excited to see all those stars come back to the Core Hydration Classic as we roll into the Olympic year. There's no sleep for the gym nerd as we launch into elite season.
Absolutely. All right. Well, here we go. Rotation number two. We'll see if Texas women's can maintain their lead and see what Lindenwood, Air Force, and Westchester can do to cut into it here. Over on vault in the top left of your screen, Clara Wallace will lead off for Air Force. Hyla Betts on the uneven bars for Westchester. Emily Six leading off for Texas women's on balance beam, and Simone Evans for Lindenwood on floor.
Nice full pirouette, fail handstand there. Shy on that last handstand. And Pikes down that double layout a little bit, looking for the athletes to maintain that open hip angle, but a hit nonetheless to start for Westchester.
Switch leap, straddle, quarter leap combination for Emily Six. Good job there, gets through the full turn. Been a fine start for Texas women's in the opening position on beam. Front toss, connecting it to that beat jump. Six had a season best 9.825 yesterday, delivers another great routine. Punch front full off the end. That's a wonderful start for Texas women's.
Yeah, they're gonna feel really good coming out of that opening, and their fans are going crazy. They got a lot of fans at the arena. Evans gearing up for her final pass here. Has to take that step forward out of the double back, but hangs on to it.
Good start on vault, meanwhile, for Ayla McKean, and Air Force. So they are underway in their second rotation as well.
Quad beat chaos, but we've got CHRISTINA Rodriguez for Westchester here on bars starting. A lot of the Westchester athletes do that full pirouette to open their routine, which is a more unusual combination. Couple of handstand issues throughout this routine, but wow. Really nice full twisting double back there. I love her chest position on landing.
Meanwhile, up second on beam is Sophie Hernandez after an opening 9.775 from Emily Six and a nice stuck Yurchenko tuck full by Gabriella Hartley on vault for Air Force.
Yeah, and of course, for the vault landings, you know, we think about the stick and the feet, but also the chest position, really important on those landings. I like that.
Again, when you look at the overall start values in the lineup, Air Force and Westchester not quite going to match what we're going to see in the next couple of rotations from Texas Women's and Lindenwood. So execution so important, not to give away those tenths when you're starting from a lower start value. They've got to be as clean as possible. It's not where they're going to win the meet, but they've got to give themselves a chance in this rotation to be able to get it done on the other three events.
Absolutely.
Another nice dismount there for Texas women's. Maybe just a little bit of a shuffle on the landing from Hernandez, but does a really nice job to follow up that opening 9-7-7-5 from Emily Sips.
And Trinity Caffey on floor for Lindenwood here. Really nice height on those leaps. That is an area that I would like to see more separation of the judges in those dance elements.
And unfortunately, a low vault there for Air Force. That's Gabriella Mechia, who has to come way in. Just did not get enough block off the table. That's so far of the three, the one that Air Force would like to drop if they can get some bigger hit vaults from Slipe, Willis, and Wallace in their back three in the lineup.
And a big double back to close there for Caffey. Just a little foot movement on landing, but nothing too major. Melina Ringus getting started for Westchester on bars. Oh, catch is close on that dinger, but keeps it moving. Nice double layout there. Were some pretty major deductions in that catch on the ginger and subsequent recovery swing, but really nice way to recover.
A couple of balance checks here in the routine from Daisy Woodring off to the side on that back handspring layout, step out, and a little bobble out of a leap combination as well. Fighting through it. Up fourth, Maggie Slife.
Goodness gracious, she's got so much power on that 1.5. Better job than we saw from her in the semifinals. In the semifinals, she landed pretty low on that, so good to see her recover there in that one of those 10-0 start values.
And unfortunately, a big break for Daisy Woodring out of that front toss beat jump combination. Saved it, stayed on the beam, but some pretty major deductions here. Finishes up, nice dismount, but just not exactly what Texas women's wanted after those two early hit routines. They were looked for their back three of King, Burkage, and Hoyland to try to finish strong.
Nia Krause on floor for Lindenwood here. Good control out of that front layout.
Fifth for Air Force on vault, Sarah Willis. Urchenko layout full, came in chest down a little bit, had to take a step forward. It's been a recurring problem here for Air Force in this rotation. Slife scoring a 9.25 off of that 10-0 start value. Urchenko layout 1.5.
And Melina Ringus on bars for Westchester here. Nice double pike for Krause to close. Some shape issues in that double layout. Again, as I mentioned, so many athletes doing those double layouts. Really want to see the hip angle extended throughout, but she did a nice job of controlling that landing.
We're back on beam for Texas women's Woodring, 9.45. So trying to bounce back. Steely King up fourth. Oh, and a big break, and now a fall off of the series. Trying to hang on to that back handspring layout, step out, cannot. So King falls, and that 9.45 you see on the screen from Woodring will have to count for the final team score. So Texas Women's runs into some trouble here on beam. Good vault in the anchor position by Clara Wallace.
Yeah, and Clara Wallace, of course, nice life, you know, their top scoring all-arounder coming in. But Claire Wallace coming in doing a great job as a freshman as well for Air Force. She's one to keep your eye on.
Air Force is officially at the halfway mark. Oh, nice dismount, round off one and a half from King, but tough one there. First real mistake from Texas women's that we've seen tonight as King will take the fall and now looking for some big numbers with their last two routines.
And Nia Kraus, 9.85, well-deserved. I really love her lines on that event. As Sarah Eskew here for Westchester. Big double layout. I love the dynamics in that, just that step back. Beckley here on floor for Lindenwood.
See that 9.725 come in for Air Force. That was from Clara Wallace to close out the scoring. So at a 97 at the midway point. Easy math, 194 pace.
Good control out of that one and a half front layout. I would like to see a little bit more rise in the front layout. Ideally, you want to see the second salto rise higher than the first, but she did a good job of controlling that landing.
A big routine in the bottom left. Emma Berklage for Texas Women's. Now in your top right, good series. Following a fall for the Pioneers.
Does a nice job of keeping her back leg up in that tricky switch split combination. And get ready on bars, Jordan Coleman. Big air time here on this Jaeger. Clinging connection to the overshoot. Little shy on that last handstand.
And a really nice finish by Berklage.
And a great finish by Coleman as well. Westchester school record holder on bars, 9.925, which I had the honor of commentating earlier this season.
You can see why when you look at her dynamics, that Jaeger is as advertised. Excellent routine there. And Westchester will feel good about how they will head into the halfway point. That was a big time routine by Berklage. Picked her team up right as things were starting to get off a little bit. Now you have Caitlin Hoyland in the anchor position, and Texas women's can limit the damage. They'll have to count that 9.45, but they can drop the 9.1 from Steely King with another good hit routine. Open here for Lindenwood to make up some ground. 9.775 score.
And Jaylee Jones on floor here for Lindenwood. Good control out of that double pike. Again, a really controlled lunge out of that.
Now in the anchor position for Texas Women's is Caitlin Hoyland. .75 from Berklage, that is the high beam score tonight.
And 8.75 from Coleman as well in that anchor spot for Westchester.
A spring combination from Hoyland. Very nicely done.
Routine from Jones on floor as well. Again, would have liked to see a little more rise out of that last pass into that second salto, but I love the control that she had on all of her tumbling passes.
Cat leap side aerial combination here from Hoyland as we go full screen. The dismount.
Huge routine for Texas women's. First of all, I love that dismount. I love the front full. Don't see that too often, and right, as you mentioned, when Texas women's needed it.
Yeah, well, they did their damage in the 5 and 6 spots in the first rotation. They had those back-to-back 9.85s, which staked them to a lead. And, well, you get the 9.875 here from Berklage and another great routine from Hoyland. We'll see what this scores. And they did an excellent job as that beam rotation was just starting to get away from them. And this is turning into the heavyweight battle that we expected to set up between Texas Women's and Lindenwood as they start to distance themselves just a bit from the back.
And, you know, speaking of closing out, I know that the Lindenwood fans are excited to see Gayla Griswold back in the floor lineup. Missed some meets in the middle part of the season due to a non-gymnastics injury and competed on floor in the semifinals as well as on vault. She is the record holder on both of those events for Lindenwood. Great to see her back on floor because she is really special on this event.
Yeah, what a difference she made coming back yesterday. 9.875, as you mentioned, she is the record holder with a 9.975 for Linda, which she's also got 9.95 on vault. So huge to have her back.
And actually, I believe she's got 9.975 on vault as well. We'll have to confirm, but I think she's gotten a 10 from one judge before on vault. And just drills that double pike to start. And again, just displaying that really crisp control of that landing. When I say controlled lunge, what I mean is you want the gymnast to be taking a step in the direction of the tumbling pass. So if it's a forward pass, a step forward. If it's a back tumbling pass, a step backward. And keeping the other foot anchored so you're not seeing any foot movement. And she just really does an excellent job of that. And just comes in short there. Again, that's an example. She took that lunge forward instead of back. So you want to see the controlled step in the direction of that tumbling pass. But nonetheless, really nice routine from her. And she's such a seasoned athlete, wonderful to watch on floor.
Well, this has really tightened up. You see the 9.825 from Hoyland. So Texas women's 97.425 for the moment. They are 0.75 up on Lindenwood, but Lindenwood going to have a chance to answer here. They'll drop that 9.7 from Trinity Caffey and think that Griswold provided just enough likely to put Lindenwood into the lead. But what we know is it is going to be extremely close at the midway point. Air Force in third with a 97 flat. And Westchester just 0.5 back, or now 5.25 as we see a potential score change there of a 96.475 for Westchester. So that is where we stand with one score left to come in for Griswold on floor. Scores at the midway point, with Texas women's trying to hang on to a lead at the moment. We're going to check in now with Air Force and their head coach Jennifer Green to talk about what winning a USAG national championship would mean to the Air Force program.
This championship is another opportunity for our athletes to experience what it's like to qualify into postseason. Anytime you can feel and experience what a championship feels like, the more you kind of have the will to get back here and do it again.
It showcases some incredible talent that we have all over the country. And probably the best part is that we get to know, hear other people's stories, learn what their struggles are, and can have a mutual respect and appreciation for each other and what everybody's journey looks like and how different it can be. These are some amazingly brilliant young women who are going to lead our country in the next years to come. So it's neat to see the quality of athletics and obviously the brilliant minds they have. So I think our future is bright.
Well, folks, if you're watching us tonight on Virtius, make sure to not skip the YouTube channel either. Virtius has covered over 150 competitions this season, including nearly one-third of NCAA programs. So you can watch all the highlights and stay in the loop for future events. More programs will be joining next year, and guess what? It is all free to you thanks to the support of local and national sponsors. So make sure to go to YouTube, hit that subscribe button, keep up with the live scoring and streaming events, and to keep Virtius going, trying to get to 1,000 subscribers on the YouTube page. And CHRISTINA, again, as the season's coming to an end, here's your homework. You can go back and check out anything you may have missed from a very busy 2024 season here on the Virtius YouTube page.
You know, Kevin, are you really even a gym nerd if you aren't watching back a random dual meet in July just for fun? No, you're not. So let us know, you know, let us know on Twitter or X, I should say, which meets you're planning on going back and rewatching or maybe watching for the first time after NCAA season is over.
Yeah, awesome product. And for all of the gymnastic streams out there that are behind paywalls, this is completely free, which is awesome. You can go back and catch up anytime you want. If you just can't get enough of me and CHRISTINA, we've got you covered. So don't worry. Even though we're going away in the off season, our voices will still live on with you. And a reminder that tonight, if you are ready for a break from our voices, of course, you can check out the apparatus streams on Vault, Bars, Beam, and Floor. This is the main stream where you're going to see all four events going on simultaneously, embrace all of the chaos of the quad meet. But if you want to tune it out, focus in on a specific event or a specific team, you could do that. Click on the buttons right below the main window right here on the Virtius platform. All right, so now we are headed to rotation number three. As you can see, we've got a dead heat. Lindenwood able to pull into a tie for first with Texas Women's 97-425. Just ahead of Air Force by 4.25 tenths. Air Force with a 97 flat. And that score actually got corrected up for Westchester to a 96-550. So they are now within 4.5 tenths of Air Force for third. In the third rotation, it will be Lindenwood on vault, Air Force on uneven bars, Westchester on balance beam, and Texas Women's on floor exercise. As we come back live here, a look at the touch warm-ups, and CHRISTINA doesn't get much more even than tied up at the halfway point. Everything we expected in this matchup between Texas Women's and Lindenwood, of course, still time for Air Force or Westchester to try to put some pressure on the top two teams in tonight's competition.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Kevin, I just love when it's coming in so deadlocked. Of course, lots of folks will refer to Beam as the make-or-break event. And, you know, honestly, I think it depends on your team. You're looking at a Westchester here in the bottom left. They got some really strong Beam workers in their lineup, but still lots of gymnastics ahead. And I think that it's really exciting to see Texas Women's and Lindenwood dueling it out as we anticipated they would be. If you'd asked me in January what would be happening at this point in the season, this is probably what I would have predicted.
Yeah, and statistically, you do get Westchester and Air Force, the two teams in third and fourth on their best events here. For Air Force, that has been bars this season where they have gone 49-4. I mean, if they do anything close to
unreal
that tonight, that's going to change the complexion of this meet in a very, very big way. Westchester's best event this year has been Beam as well. So we'll see what the Rams are able to do. And you know, this 1-2 battle between Texas Women's and Lindenwood will move on. Texas Women's on floor, they had a 48.825 yesterday. Lindenwood 48.775. Statistically, this has been their weakest event this season, where they are 49th in the country.
Can we also just talk about, Kevin, these gymnasts at Air Force, you're going to a service academy and competing on a college athletics team at the same time. The talent and the dedication that these athletes have is unbelievable.
Yeah, there is infamously an abundance of free time when you are right. at a service academy to be filling that out with the hours that you're putting in the gym to do the work that they do. And I thought it was a really interesting and insightful conversation we had with Jennifer Green this week, talking about how the gym is actually kind of their place to get away from some of the pressures that come with campus. There's so much competition built into every phase of your life at the Air Force Academy, be it in the military context, in the academic context. It's a great school, of course, and in the gym. But this is their chance to just get to be together, to have fun, to be a team. And she says this team has really embraced that mindset, and obviously it has paid off in a big way to put them here in the Final Four for the USAG Collegiate National Championship.
And just finished the touch warm-up period here, so we'll be getting started momentarily.
Once again, just to recap, Lindenwood on vault, that's top left. Air Force on bars, top right. Westchester on beam, bottom left, and Texas Women's on floor, bottom right, and the Pioneers are underway. First vault for Lindenwood, Yurchenko layout full from Hannah Applegate. Landed with that chest down a little bit. Overall, clean vault and underway on beam, Natalie Marshall.
And clean work through this little, just as I said, that little labored in that stalter. Takes that step forward on that double back. But otherwise, clean work for Boyer for Air Force.
Cavalier side aerial there for Marshall.
And short on that double back, takes that lunge forward but keeps it to her feet there. For Texas women, six wrapping up there.
Gainer Pike off the end of the beam, just a little step on the dismount, but Marshall very happy about that one as Applegate begins the vault rotation for Lindenwood with a 9.725. Here is Jenny Jones, Yurchenko layout full, a little bit bigger that time. And step off to the side.
You have a nice dynamics in that full. I like the block she got off the table.
Well, we have just a quick moment here. I do want to remind you that CHRISTINA and I will be back with you tomorrow right here on the Virtius platform. Just before 1 p.m. Eastern, we'll get underway with the individual event finals, which is something, CHRISTINA, I know you and I are really excited to be a part of. USAG, the only competition still bringing the individual event finals to the screen, and it should be a really fun day tomorrow as we get to crown national champions in vault, bars, beam, and floor. And again, a shout out to Morgan Price, who made history yesterday by winning the individual all-around championship, bringing home the first national title for Fisk.
Absolutely agree. Can't wait to commentate those routines tomorrow. Broshi, little close catch on that Ginger. And, you know, when you catch close, it can lead to a labored swing out of it. But she's kept the momentum going.
And you see Reese Beckley up third on vault for Lindenwood. Far and away the biggest vault. You do notice those directional lines. They are there as a guideline. It's not a neutral deduction for stepping out. Landed with her left foot just on that line, a little bit off directionally, but much better block, good distance off of the table there for Beckley.
And nice double pike there on floor.
Just a little check and then having to pull that leg up on the series on McCarthy Keene, who's up second for Westchester. Up fourth, Allie Berkeley. Sky high, Yurchenko full. That was the most controlled vault for Lindenwood so far.
Just a little off directionally on that Rudy to close for Texas women on floor, but handles the landing.
Nice dismount, meanwhile, for Keen on beam.
Separation in that Maloney on bars for Wallace, but keeps the momentum going in the bail handstand. Shy on that last handstand. I love this dismount though, the toe on front half. So cool. You don't see that often enough. Pretty old school, back from when I was doing club gymnastics level old school. But really cool to see that.
Air Force now halfway home on bars. Over on vault, Trinity Caffey be up next for Lindenwood up fifth. Sarah Eskew on the beam up third for Westchester. Big Yurchenko full, and you see the big hop back out of it for Caffey. A lot of power in that one. Series there for Westchester.
Nice double back on floor there for Texas women's.
This is Sophia Isbell up third for Texas women's. SQ finishes up for Westchester.
A nice full pirouette to double back for Carlisle there for Air Force to wrap up her routine. Just a couple of minor form errors throughout, but strong routine overall.
A good vault in the anchor position as Lindenwood finishes up on vault.
And really pretty performance quality from Isbell too there. And I, again, if fans that have heard me commentate know this is my soapbox. We only have 3/10 dedicated towards artistry in the NCAA gymnastics code. I think it should be way more in order to appropriately reward these athletes that are going above and beyond within the current code limits for performance.
Up fourth, now top right of your screen as we go to the triple box. This is Madison Whitaker for Westchester. Top left on the uneven bars, Ayla McKean for Air Force.
And just a little flow in that catch through the Jaeger, but again, keeps that connection really important there. Nice job on that full pirouette. just that slide back on the double back.
Back handspring layout step out, a little bit of form in there, but overall well controlled.
Just a little low on that landing for the front toss, but she does maintain the connection into the beat jump.
Dealey King over on floor for Texas Women's, trying to bounce back after that tough fall on beam in the last rotation.
Good control out of that double pipe to open.
By the way, I do want to circle back on Griswold's 985 vault. That's the high vault score for Lindenwood. And CHRISTINA, we were both, you were more right. 9975 was the career high for Griswold. She got that as a sophomore. 995 season high score. Ready to go in the anchor position for Air Force on the uneven bars.
And really nice ring position there on floor for King for Texas Women's. And Maggie Slife, such a great bar worker. Good control out of that final pass for King. Look at this big, huge full twisting double back for Slight. She keeps her legs together. The toes are pointed in the air. Really so exceptional. By the way, I think that she got underscored at regionals on bars. And I really think that she should have gone higher there. Didn't have her absolute cleanest performance all around at regionals, but certainly one to watch, just a freshman.
That dismount is, that's a stunner. The amount of height that she gets and the time she has to spot up that landing is outstanding. On the beam now on the left side of your screen is Caroline Cascadden for Westchester.
And, you know, she's so seasoned, she was actually just a little bit off on her front foot, but she was patient, leaned into the correction, and handled it no problem.
Low number right now for Westchester in this rotation is a 9-4. Billy McFarland in the anchor spot up next. See the 9-9 come up for Slight. 9-9-5 for one judge.
Yeah, to be honest, I was probably with the 9-9 judge, but still fantastic performance. Just a little step forward there for Cascadden. She is the program record holder for Westchester on beam, 9-9-2-5. Won't see that today, but she's really got some nice qualities on beam.
Absolutely. One more routine to come for Westchester. That'll be Lily McFarland. Over on floor exercise on the right side of your screen is Daisy Woodring for Texas Women's.
Full front layout, keeps that in bounds. She went out of bounds on that in the semifinals, so good for her. No problem on that double back there.
Farland, a small balance check on that cat leap side aerial combination.
And Woodring, really nice control, as I mentioned. I double back, another program record holder in this competition, 9.95 for career high there on floor. You know, pace forward on that dismount, but a lot of grit in that routine for sure.
We will have one routine left in this third rotation. It will belong to Sophie Hernandez for Texas Rings as we await the scores from Daisy Woodring.
Right, and you know, I think...
Go ahead,
Kev.
Low score for Emily Six, who is 9.625, so that's the number that Texas Women's is trying to drop. We'll see what Woodring scores, and then Hernandez in the anchor position.
Yeah, you know, I think one of the really nice things about this, the back end, you've got Woodring and Hernandez in that 5 and 6 spot, showing multiple double salto passes, a lot of great control on landing. You know, there's a lot of debate going on in NCAA gymnastics right now about the two-pass routines and the lack of difficulty needed to start from a 10.0. So I really appreciate those athletes that are doing multiple double salto passes, that are doing more difficulty than they need.
Yeah, it's gonna be an interesting offseason, Christina. Next year is a rule change year, so there are certainly some proposals that are floating out there. I'd be curious to see what it looks like in the NCAAs next year. Finishing
up through
with Hernandez.
It's a double pike. Huge power there. Front layout to close there. Just little lack of precision on that last landing, but minor deduction. Another one of those athletes from Texas Women, gotta say, I love the choreography from Texas Women. Really high level of performance. And yeah, that front through to double pike, that was a highlight of the routine for me. Love to see that difficulty.
Well, as Lindenwood and Texas Women's have separated themselves from the pack, Lindenwood, a 48.9 on vault. We'll see what Texas Women's ends up with here in their final score from Sophie Hernandez, which is yet to come in. It would take a 9.9 unofficially to pull even, but either way, going to be extremely tight as we head to the fourth and final rotation, with Texas Women's finishing up on vault, Lindenwood on bars, Air Force on beam, and Westchester on floor exercise. So there are your rotation three totals. And as we step away, we've been asking our coaches what a USAG championship would mean to them. And we're going to hear from the two teams that are best positioned to take one home tonight, Lindenwood and Texas Women's, as we'll come back with the fourth and final rotation here from Westchester.
Obviously, this year has been really unique for us in our program, just this being the last of kind of everything. So winning USAGs for us would mean so much, just to obviously like our coaching staff, each individual athlete, but really even more so just like the legacy of our program and everything that, you know, Lindenwood Gymnastics has stood for these past 12 seasons. And so we're obviously doing it for us and, you know, the hard work we put in this year, but it's really so much more than that. It's for every single team that has come before us and coaching staff, so.
Yeah, so this championship is so very special to our program. We've obviously been competing in this championship for many, many years, and having won 10 championships you know, it just, it means everything. Giving these athletes opportunity to compete for a national championship, to compete with some of the best gymnasts in the nation, is just something we look forward to every single year. We're so grateful for the group of coaches and athletes who work so hard to just make this championship top notch, to make sure it's competitive every year. And yeah, it's something that, you know, so many of our athletes have just the absolute best memories and experiences from college and getting to compete in this championship. So we're grateful and we are excited to be back for another year.
A reminder, folks, as we are bringing you the main feed tonight with all of the routines in all of the events, if you want to dial in on a specific team or specific event, just click on the apparatus streams. You can get vault bars, beam, or floor in addition to our quad box coverage. As we get set for the fourth and final rotation, a team national championship just six routines away. Texas Women's and Lindenwood separating themselves from the pack, but Air Force pulling up a big 49 flat on bars. They are within striking distance as well, just 3 1/4 tenths back. Westchester with a 144.850 as we get set for the fourth and final rotation. And folks, if you're enjoying tonight's coverage and have an event in mind and can talk about gymnastics for 2 hours at a time, as Christina and I, certainly 2 hours is a minimum number for us, not a maximum.
Absolute minimum.
I would say you can find us on social media. You won't really find me, but Christina is out and about in the Gymternet discourse. So Christina, if anyone wants to mix it up with you, where can they find you to chat more gymnastics after the broadcast tonight?
Yeah, I'm on the artist formerly known as Twitter, CHAUVENET. So gym fans, would love for you to reach out to us and let us know how you're enjoying the stream and what event, what routines you're enjoying tonight.
And if you're more interested in getting involved, it is absolutely as fun as Christina and I make it seem like it is. Virtius is always on the lookout for creative broadcast and or technical talent, so you can reach out to them as well. No prior experience required, just a love for the sport and a desire to share it with the world. So find and follow them on social media or email them directly for more information. And we thank our partners at Virtius for bringing us this wonderful event coverage, allowing us to bring it to you as well as we look at the lineups for rotation number four. And we teased this ahead of time, Christina. Texas Women's and Lindenwood finishing on vault and bars, respectively. They're separated by just half a tenth. They are finishing on their strongest events, and it should be great. And to see if Air Force can come in from behind the pack and really knock it out on balance beam and try to chase these two down. You've got three teams that are all separated by 3 1/4 tenths. Promises to be an exciting finish.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, as you mentioned, you see that slim separation between Texas Women's and Lindenwood. Air Force, not that far behind. And so, you know, they do have the challenge of ending on beam. They've got some great beam workers in their lineup. And, you know, for Westchester, not mathematically in the chase for the title, but an opportunity for them to end on a very high note in front of their home crowd. They have some fantastic floor routines. They made upgrades from last season. I'm really looking forward to their performance.
Yeah, anytime you get floor on your home floor, it's always something special. We have seen it is a packed building tonight. The energy, the atmosphere here has been great. Yeah, this is just a chance for Westchester. You're going out, you're having fun, you're celebrating as a team one final time, and it should be a really interesting final rotation underway. And Christina, I do want to circle back to something that we touched on at the beginning of the night, and that is Lindenwood. And of course, you know, the magnitude of this moment is magnified by the fact that it is their final competition, as Lindenwood is no longer going to be sponsoring women's gymnastics after this season. And I just have to say, the pressure, the emotion that this team has had to carry throughout this season, everything has been a last everything, last meet at home, last conference championship, last USAG, to carry all of that weight, to be the favorite entering tonight's competition, and now to hold the lead by half a tenth. I've been in awe of this program for a long time as a fan of them, and I think the challenge that has been laid out for them this year and the way that they have overcome that amount of adversity, I really just can't imagine.
Yeah, so poignantly said, Kevin, and I know I speak for both of us when I say it's truly an absolute honor to commentate their final competition. And I just, you know, you mentioned only a third division, non-division one team to qualify to NCAA regionals, qualified back in 2019. And so I just wish all the athletes well. You know, we probably will see some of their athletes in the transfer portal and looking to continue their career. So regardless of whether they're continuing their careers or calling it a day, congratulations to them, and what a loss for the gymnastics community. And CHRISTINA, show them some love. I know everybody's been showing them love, but definitely show them love. And some of their athletes will be with us tomorrow for event finals as well.
Absolutely, and a reminder that CHRISTINA and I will be back with you 1 p.m. Eastern tomorrow, individual event finals, as we will crown individual national champions on vault, bars, beam, and floor to go with our individual all-around champion, Morgan Price, which was crowned yesterday in the semifinals. So we are ready to go with Texas women's on vault and Emma Berklage getting things started with a very nice controlled Yurchenko layout vault.
Yeah, great way to start that rotation. Yeah, it's really hard for me to pick a favorite here coming into this final rotation, because as you mentioned, both of these teams that are in the lead are on their statistically best events.
You know, the Texas women's had some issues on vault yesterday. Cami Zarlengo opened with a 9-1. They flipped her and Berklage in the lineup, and at least seems to have paid off thus far, with Berklage getting a really nice start set for Texas women's. We're going to know what the number is as they'll be finished first on vault, and Lindenwood going to try to chase him down right now. A half a tenth cushion for Lindenwood, and then Air Force trying to catch them both from behind. You see the opening 9.825 from Berklage. Lindenwood gets underway on the bars with Jaylee Jones. Second vault already complete by Cami Zarlengo.
And big triple series there for Clara Wallace. Again, that freshman leads off on multiple events. Great stuck dismount there for Lindenwood.
In the future, so bright for Air Force with some of their underclassmen. My goodness, this is going to be a team that is going to be back in this position moving forward. We've also got Bridget Sullivan opening up on floor exercise, bottom right of your screen for Westchester.
A nice control out of that first tumbling pass. And you can just see the joy in the way that Westchester is competing. Absolutely love that for them.
Oh, another really good vault there by Texas women's. Trying to pull those feet together, hang on to the stick. Not quite, little shuffle by Steely King. But overall, again, a nice vault, clean line coming off the table. I thought that was really well done after a 9.825, 9.725 opening.
Although, you know, Kevin, I have to say, I think she got so excited she might incur that half-tenth deduction. I don't know if she held the finish position
That's possible. That is certainly possible. All right, up second is Reese Beckley on the uneven bars, top right of your screen for Lindenwood.
And another great dismount. You're starting to see the emotion show here for Lindenwood, and as you mentioned, Kevin, have just been rising to the occasion. Really nice dismount there.
Yeah, I was wondering if just a little bit of that pressure was getting to them on the balance beam. They just looked a little tight. You know, some of those balance checks early, but they have settled in, and there's a stuck vault, a little bit piked in the landing position, but again, clean control, and Texas women's giving it all they've got right here. Sophia Isbell completes the fourth vault for the Pioneers, two to come from Daisy Woodring and Caitlin Hoyland.
Yeah, and you know, I think the challenge when you're finishing on vault in particular, you have to be careful not to go for the stick too hard. So sometimes you'll see athletes open up a little early for that, and I think that's what she might have done there, just result in a little forward body position.
All right, up second on floor, bottom right is Lily McFarland for Westchester. A little bit of a delay over on the beam before Maggie Slife will go second for Air Force. That's Daisy Woodring on vault.
And yeah, McFarland ends with that really nicely controlled double pike on floor.
No issues on the series for Slife on beam, meanwhile. Good full turn. 1 final vault, and Texas women's will be the clubhouse leader. See what the school to beat is for Lindenwood and Air Force.
Come on, that punch front is huge.
You want to talk about attacking a beam routine.
Yeah.
Final vault now, maybe the best of the night. Huge Yurchenko layout full from Caitlin Hoyland. And Texas women's finishes up their USAG National Championship competition.
And Kaylee Cooper there on bars for Lindenwood. Again, you can just see the emotion coming to them. They are all just stoked for each other. And I can they're really getting the job done here on bars.
Boy, it is just punch for punch right now. It's you got Air Force opening with a 9-7, 8-7-5 from Wallace, awaiting the score for Maggie Slife. And they're not going quietly. And Texas Women's and Lindenwood trading mid-9-8 scores back and forth. It is everything you could ask for here in the fourth rotation. Sarah Eskew, meanwhile, on floor.
And another athlete doing one of those double salto passes, that double back. Nice control in her leap series.
Wow, now trading 9-9 for 9-9. Hoyland's 9-9 comes up, then Cooper's for Lindenwood.
And this is what I hope that folks, if you're tuning in, maybe you don't watch Division II gymnastics very often, I hope you're seeing the really great level of talent that there is in Division II and some of the smaller Division I programs.
49-1-7-5 for Texas Women's on vault. That is a new season-high vault score, and they post a 195-450, so that is the number to beat.
Nia Kraus getting started here with that big ray. Little leg separation in the overshoot, but keeps it moving.
Kylie Green, meanwhile, on the balance beam after 9-8-7-5, 9-8-5 scores to start.
Just a step back, but really high, nice, full twisting double back. She's stoked about that one, I think.
I think so. Well, there's no reason to hold anything back now, and they are not.
Absolutely.
And it has brought out the best in Lindenwood in this rotation. A nice, neat combination there by Green on the beam.
I love a standing layout step out, so powerful.
Round off 1.5, and gotta hang on to it.
Yeah, and what I liked about that is she was a little off balance in landing, actually, but you saw her take her time, sink her heels in, and held on. She'll probably get a half 10 for that lean to the side, but didn't have to incur the step.
Well, and that is just a textbook, you know, example of how that change to the end of routine, the emphasis of it this year, the change that it has had. Because before, you would just quickly step out of that into the salute as quick as possible.
Right.
And keep it
the
moving.
Old college stick.
College stick and walk right off the mat. So I think it's been a change for the better. And, nice fight there at the end by Green. Air Force is halfway home.
Hannah Moon.
7-5, meanwhile, from Kraus. Great scores from Lindenwood here on bars.
Yeah, they are bringing it. Moon getting started here on bars. So leg separation in that Maloney and in the bail to handstand, but connects it nicely up to the high bar. And I like that she does that toe shoot up.
Holy moly. Huge double lay out there. The way that that rose off of that bar, that was textbook. Fantastic dismount there for Hannah Moon.
Yep, that was, you stole the word. I was going to say the same. She got better as that routine went on. Excellent finish, great punctuation mark. And now just one routine to go. We'll see if the combination of Hannah Moon and Hannah Applegate will have enough for Lindenwood to hold off the charge from a season-high vault score from Texas Women's. 195-450 is the number right now. We'll see the score here from Moon and know whether Lindenwood unofficially has enough to repeat as USAG national champions.
As CHRISTINA Rodriguez on floor here for Westchester.
Kimberly Kincaid on the beam, meanwhile, for Air Force as well.
And Rodriguez, one of my favorite gymnasts to watch on floor, just has really lovely lines and dedication to performance.
Well, you see the score for Moon. It's a 9-9. Lindenwood moves ahead, 195-675 with one routine to go. And they have put themselves in position to bring home a national title in their final meet.
Double back, duck coal by Rodriguez there. And yeah, I have to say, I did find that score for Moon a little high, just based on some of the leg separation earlier in the routine. But still, I do think overall they deserve to go in front there, as you mentioned too, with one routine left.
49-350 on bars, and it does happen sometimes in these fourth rotation of quad meets, championship meets, that the potential for scoring opens up. And they have surged past what they did on Friday. It's already a season-high score by a full tenth, and they will try to add to it here and put the punctuation mark on a national title with Hannah Applegate on the bars.
Nice ginger there. I love how she kept her legs together. The overshoot, I think she caught a little bit close. The way that Lindenwood is drilling these dismounts is uncanny. You can tell how bad they want it. And as I mentioned, I think she caught a little close on that overshoot. And a lot of times what'll happen is you'll see athletes fall or have a really labored swing to get back up to the high bar. No problem there. She just willed herself through that last part of that bar routine.
Well, and you could see her take that extra moment or two after sticking that landing to take it all in. And Lindenwood as a program will take it all in as well. Unofficially, they will repeat as USAG national champions in the most dramatic fashion possible as their program comes to an end here in 2024 to go out on top. Just a true testament to the work that Lindenwood has done this season. You see that score tick up to a 195-7, which matches what they did yesterday in qualifying. Over on floor, Kylie Fred for Westchester.
Nice job in that switch side to Wolf Full, getting that Wolf Full all the way around. Oh, and really muscles that up there. Good for her for keeping that combination pass to her feet.
Gabriella Hartley, meanwhile, up fifth on beam for Air Force.
And this combo is so cool on beam. Check this out. Handstand step down, backhand spring layout step out. Love to see that. Whip to 1.5, nice control on that final pass for Fred. And just one routine left for Westchester here to close out their night. You know, with Hartley, that combo, I just love the handstand step down skills. And if you're a hardcore gym fan, old school. You'll remember Morgan Lane doing the press handstand to layout, step out, kind of reminds me of that style, but really cool combination and sticks that dismount too.
And now one routine left for Air Force as well. So closing in on the end of our team competition tonight, you can see those scores. Now everything unofficial until it is signed, sealed, and delivered, but a 2.5 tenth cushion for Lindenwood, 195.7. Texas women's, boy, they gave it all they had with a season-high vault, 49.175, but Lindenwood matched them with a season-best 49.375 on bars to pull away by 2.5 tenths. They overcame a little bit of a shaky start on beam. They trailed early, but made up that ground and never looked back.
Yeah, and as you said, I think I just have to commend Lindenwood for handling those emotions in that final rotation. You know, both of those top two teams had some struggles on beam and had to come back from that for their final events, and really impressed with what Texas women's did as well. But of course, as you mentioned, extra emotion. We will see some of those Lindenwood gymnasts in the event finals tomorrow, but their last team competition here.
Yeah, and they wore that emotion in every reaction, every landing. Most of them stuck landings here in that final bars rotation. And yeah, quite a moment as now we get the final beam routine for Air Force. Ayla McKean will bring us home on the balance beam.
And I really enjoy watching her on beam as well. Just sets herself up really nicely for that landing of that layout step out, brings her arms right down to secure her landing.
Caroline Cascaden getting underway as the final floor routine and final routine of the night for Westchester.
Just that step forward and chest down on that double pike. Getting control out of that
pike finish there by McKean.
One and a half punch front, nice control out of that landing. She's such a fun athlete to watch on floor and really a great way for Westchester to end their historic season. Again, first time qualifying to USAG Finals.
Yeah, really special, and to get to have that moment on your home floor in front of this terrific home crowd here in the Hollinger Pavilion. I mean, what a night this has been. Just great support for all four of these teams, but nice for Westchester to get a moment. They made history this season, making this USAG Finals for the first time, and it was a terrific night of competition. I think a lot for each of these teams to take away, and Lindenwood shines brightest with a 195.7 season-high bars to cap off their second straight USAG title and their fifth overall and final USAG title in program history.
Yeah, we've already said so many things about Lindenwood and what they've meant for college gymnastics, but what a way to go out.
Absolutely, and we want to remind you folks that as you've been watching our coverage tonight, Virtius, they are in the arena, they are providing the fan experience, on the floor experience, live scoring, scoreboarding, so many things that this competition platform can do. So if you are watching the experience either in the venue tonight or here on the website, if you're looking to upgrade your scoring and fan engagement in 2025, reach out to the Virtius team. They want to help make that happen. We know that you're already thinking about next year. I know CHRISTINA and I are already thinking about our plans for 2025. So if you are at all interested, either on the floor, in the fan zone, or behind the scenes, reach out to the folks at Virtius. Go to virtius.com and get in touch with the Virtius team. We can make it happen for you, as they have for so many NCAA programs. And here at USAG Championships, here is our final event summary, rotation number 4. And boy, so much to take away from this one. Back and forth we went, with scores 9-8-5, 9-9 between Lindenwood and Texas Women's. Everything that we wanted to see. In the end, both teams record season highs in that final rotation, but Lindenwood just a bit higher, 2/10 over Texas Women's, and they win it by 2.5/10, a 195-7 for Lindenwood. They take first, 195-450 for Texas Women's taking second, 194-850 for Air Force third, and Westchester fourth with a 193-1 at the moment. Still one score to come in for Cascadon, and we expect that that number will tick up by a few tenths.
Yeah, as you mentioned, you know, just so great to see Lindenwood and Texas Women going for it, going for broke in that final rotation. Can't ask for a better finish there. Lot for Air Force to be proud of. They have so much young talent coming up. Clara Wallace, Maggie Slife. It's the future is really bright for Air Force. And, you know, for Westchester on floor, really liked the performance quality that they brought to floor. You could tell they were having a great time. A lot of their athletes have upgraded. They're showing more of those double salto passes, and I love to see it.
Absolutely. Definitely something for each of these teams to take away. But Lindenwood caps it off with a team national title here in 2024. So that is your team event summary. Let's take a look at our individual event leaderboards. Now, remember, these are not the national champions on these events. These are the winners from tonight. We are going to hand out individual hardware tomorrow, USAG, to their credit, as individual event finals. CHRISTINA and I will be back with you at 1 p.m. But Caitlin Hoyland setting the tone tonight, the only 9-9 score on vault, part of that great Texas Women's vault rotation in the fourth and final rotation, CHRISTINA.
Yeah, really exciting to see that big stuck vault from her, and we're going to see some really great vaults tomorrow in the event finals as well.
Yep, moving over to the uneven bars tonight as we look at our final totals, a three-way tie with 9-9s. Maggie Slife, a terrific routine for Air Force, and then a pair of 9-9s in that final rotation as part of that 49.375 overall for Lindenwood. Kaylee Cooper and Hannah Moon will share in the uneven bars title here in the team final.
Yeah, and you know, the Kaylee Cooper, Hannah Moon, those Lindenwood athletes really nailing their dismounts on bars, and that was a big part of the difference. Maggie Slife, this is the score she deserved at regionals, by the way, 9-9, well deserved.
Absolutely, and it comes here in the USAG team finals. Excited to see her in action tomorrow as well. Looking at balance beam, this was an event where there were some struggles for the top teams, but you had Emma Berkledge come up with that 9.875. Berkledge helped lead the way, along with Clara Wallace from Air Force in that final rotation. 9.875 score. Maggie Slife just a quarter of a tenth behind with a 9.85. And again, beam should be a fun one to watch tomorrow as well.
Yeah, really critical routine there for Berkledge in for Texas Women. Again, had those mistakes, but great to see her hit that. Clara Wallace, as I said, I think she is one of the other up-and-coming stars for Air Force.
Yeah, they are going to be back. I fully expect to see them in this competition again next season if they can bring everyone back and continue next season. Now on floor exercise, the final of our individual event leaderboards, have a two-way tie here for first at 9.85, again between the two teams that were battling it out for first all night. Nia Kraus from Lindenwood with a 9.85. Sophie Hernandez from Texas Women's 9.85. Scoring was a little bit higher in the semifinals on floor. It was a little bit tighter tonight, I thought, overall. But two deserving routines there, going 9.85 for Kraus and Hernandez.
Yeah, and what I like about those, the way that they scored these routines, is those top routines really had that exemplary control out of the tumbling passes, especially those double salto passes.
Absolutely. And now a look at the all-around leaderboard as we come out of floor exercise. This is tonight's all-around leaderboard, a 39.375 for Maggie Slife. So she'll take home the all-around honors tonight. Now, that is not the all-around national championship. We'll get to that momentarily, but no taking away what Slife did tonight all this season. She was a regional NCAA regional competitor in all-around, and she showed us why tonight, that 39.375, heck of a performance.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, she did not have her best performance in semifinals, so really good to see her come back, rebound, and get that vault she did was so dynamic. She's chasing, by the way, the 39.475 program record. She's currently in second, has gone as high as 39.425. So, you know, the sky's the limit for her potential at Air Force.
Yeah, that's a win, not an if, from Slife if she's able to keep up what she came out and did this season. Now, we will look at the all-around leaderboard. This is from yesterday. This is your official all-around competition. Morgan Price making history for Fisk as the first winner from that school of a individual national championship, going 39.225, the first winner from an HBCU program, and so many firsts in the last couple of seasons, CHRISTINA, for Fisk. This to be another one, and I think it just validates the decision of Morgan Price to go there, to bring the attention and the awareness that she brought with her to that upstart program, and really happy to see her get her moment in the spotlight last night, taking home the individual all-around championship.
Absolutely, and we're going to see her in three event finals tomorrow. Deserve it all-around champion. I agree with everything you said. You know, she's the record holder for every single event for Fisk, admittedly, in their second season, but she's just killing it. You know, formerly was committed to Arkansas, and really great to see her bringing all of that powerful gymnastics that she does. Certainly a favorite for probably vault and floor tomorrow, so make sure to join us then.
Yeah, excited to see her and Talladega well represented as well. We're going to see Johnson and Alexa Choi in individual event finals as well. So a lot of excitement. We'll get to spotlight some other programs that we didn't get to talk as much about tonight as we had the team finals. So all-around hardware has been handed out. Now the team championship belongs to Lindenwood. We'll crown the individual event winners tomorrow at 1 p.m. Eastern. But CHRISTINA, this night it belongs to Lindenwood, and it feels kind of cosmically written that with all of the injustice that they have dealt with, and the emotion that they have had to carry with them this season, it's a night for them to celebrate, a night for them to remember forever, and what this program has been able to accomplish this season and in the all-too-short history of the Lindenwood team. You just have to tip your cap to everything they've done and hand it to this 2024 Lindenwood team for what they did tonight.
Absolutely. You know, I wish that this wasn't the last meet that Lindenwood was competing in, but unfortunately those are the circumstances, and they went, boy did they go out on a high note, just wishing again their team the best.
Absolutely, and they will take the team final tonight and hang a banner for the fifth time in program history. 195-7 the final score for Lindenwood, and we will stick around for the award ceremony here at Westchester's Hollinger Pavilion. That will do it for my partner, CHRISTINA CHAUVENET. I'm Kevin Kopp. Thank you all so much for being with us tonight. It has been an honor to bring to you the 2024 USAG Team Finals. We'll be back with you for individual event finals at 1 p.m. Eastern tomorrow. Hope that you'll join us then for another great showcase of the terrific gymnastics that this level of the sport has. And for all of us here at the Virtius team, I'm Kevin Kopp saying thank you all so much for watching. Stick around. Awards coming up from Westchester as we continue on tonight. USAG Team Finals continue next.
Better.
Do you need to put something on top of this?
I just can't have anybody in front of it because I got it going down.
Yeah, I think we're good.
Do you need to put anything on top of this to weigh it down or not?
Sure. Otherwise, you guys aren't going crazy. Yeah, see anybody walk in or stand in there?
Yeah.
She's good.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we've all been waiting for final results of the 2024 USA Gymnastics Women's Collegiate National Championships. In fourth place, with a 193.525, a Westchester University. And in third place with a 194.85, United States Air Force Academy. Championship meet tomorrow at 1 p.m.